you find inflating a balloon difficult? At least I find so. Let's make a simple air pump to inflate a balloon using this simple bottle and also understand the concept of a valve which makes an air pump work. Let's take a plastic container. We are going to make a small hole on the lid of the container. So for that, we take this divider and heat it in the candle flame. When it is hot enough, then we make a hole at the center of the cap. We take a balloon and we cut a small rectangular slice from this balloon. So we get this rectangular sheet of balloon. Now what we do is, this is the hole that we had made, right? So now what we are going to do is, we will cover this hole with this strap of balloon. But one important thing to ensure is, we will paste it here. So we just put the sellotape on two ends of this rectangular strip. So one important thing to note here is, please do not put any sellotape at the central region, just sellotape at the corner so that it stays here. That's it. Now we take one more sellotape and cover the lid very nicely so that there is no leakage in this region. Now we take this balloon, and this is the balloon which we are going to inflate using this air pump. And we fit it here on the top. Now our setup is not completely ready, but yeah, almost ready. Let's see how it works. Now we have created one hole, you remember? So let's press it here and see what happens. And you see, the moment I press it, it starts to inflate. But after some time, you know, even if I'm trying to press, but I am not able to press, what's happening basically? Now when I started pressing, all the air that was contained inside the bottle, that got transferred inside the balloon, and therefore the balloon started to inflate. But when all the air inside the bottle actually went off, so we need more air inside the bottle. So from where will more air come inside? So there is no space that no more air can enter inside the bottle. So that is why we are not able to inflate the balloon more than this. So let's see, what do we do to overcome this problem? So for this, we will again create a hole, another hole. So we take the divider, heat it enough, and create a very tiny hole somewhere here. Now what will this hole do? This hole will give a way for air to enter from the surroundings inside the bottle. Let's see how this one works. So what we have to do is, just make sure when you press the bottle, press it in such a way that your finger should cover the hole. When you release it, just release it from the hole. So let's do this. So in this fashion, you can inflate the balloon. Now do you find something very interesting? Right now I'm not doing anything with the entire setup. We have a hole on the bottle. We also have a hole at the lid. But why is it that the air that is contained inside the balloon is not coming out of the balloon? So that is what we are trying to understand. So here, the valve that we had created, that is the lid that we had created, is playing a role. So just see what happens when we remove the lid from this bottle. So even after the lid is removed from the bottle, so you can clearly see the hole, right, which we had made in the cap. But in spite of the presence of this hole, the air inside the balloon is not coming out. That's because this is acting as a valve which allows only unidirectional flow of air. Let us try to understand the functioning of this valve. So when you look at this valve closely, you see this is the top side of the valve. So on this side we have the balloon. And this is the bottom side. So on this side we have the bottle. Now what happens is, let us first try to understand the bottom side. So here, when the air from the bottle tries to enter through this hole, what happens? When it tries to enter through this hole, what do you have on the other side? You basically have this yellow piece of balloon. Now, at the middle portion, even though you have this balloon, but you have not covered it with sellotape. So if you observe closely, you see there is some space on this side. There is also some space on this side. So as a result, when air tries to enter from this side, somehow it makes some way and some of the air reaches this side. And that air enters inside the balloon, because of which the balloon inflates. Now the question is, why the vice versa doesn't happen? Why the air inside the balloon doesn't enter inside the container? Now the air inside the balloon comes through from this side. So what happens? It strikes the top surface, that is this yellow surface. So when it strikes this surface, it actually doesn't find any way to go to the other side, because the pressure of the air kind of hits this wall of the balloon, and the wall of the balloon acts as a stronger wall which doesn't allow the air to go the other side. As a result, the air doesn't enter inside the bottle. And that is why this arrangement, this very simple arrangement, acts like a valve which allows only unidirectional, that is one directional flow of air from bottle to balloon and not from balloon to bottle. So this is our final homemade air pump. So what happens when we press this bottle? What are we doing? We are pressing the bottle, so we are forcing the air to enter inside the balloon, and in between is present this valve which allows the air to enter inside, as we saw just now. Now when we release it, then what happens? Here the valve doesn't allow the air to come from the balloon inside the bottle, but at the same time this hole, it allows some air to enter inside the bottle. So we repeat this process, and as a result our balloon gets inflated. I'm sure you'll be able to make your own air pump to inflate balloons, and now you also know how exactly an air pump works. Like and share the video. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel to get daily updates. Thank you.